Namaste, I am Venkata R. Chaganti, President, Vedas World Inc., Georgia, USA. Today, I would like to talk about the creation of universe in Vedas, as explained in Vedas, as a part one. And I will show some relevance of scientific development with regards to the mantra what I am going to present here. Let's see. This is the Rig Veda mantra, 10th mandalam, 190th suktam, 3rd mantra. Om Surya Chandra Masau Dhata Yatha Purva Makalpayat Divancha Prataveen Chanta Riksha Matho Swaha. The meaning of this mantra, as given by Maharshi Dayananda Saraswati, is like this. This sun and moon, radiating stars, electricity and earth-like planets and infinite empty space and galaxies, nebula, comets, etc. were created just like in the previous creation by the God who has the capacity to hold and nourish the universe. In this mantra, everything about the creation of nature is given, not creation of humans or life. Except that, everything, whatever is there, it is the universe. So that is the nature. Let's say the sun, moon, radiating stars, electricity, earth-like planets, infinite empty space, galaxies, nebula, comets, etc. All these things are nature. The vast universe. And the important sentence is just like in the previous creation. So the most important thing is there was a previous creation before this creation. And that is possible only if there is a destruction in between these two. So in this mantra, the mantra makes us think that there was a creation before this creation, and both the creations are alike. There's no difference between that creation and this creation. So how the sun, moon, stars, electricity, earth-like planets, infinite space, galaxies, nebula, comets, etc. were created in the previous creation, in a similar manner it is created in this creation also. Because there is no discrepancy in God's knowledge. God's knowledge is complete. It doesn't have increasing or decreasing nature. Therefore, just like in the previous creation, also it indicates there was a destruction in between. Otherwise, how is it possible? Creating, you want to create once again, there should be a destruction and then a creation. So this mantra gives us a complete sense of how the creation took place, how the universe is created previously and now. So let's see if there is any scientific relevance for today's world. The universe is in a constant state of expansion, and the general consensus is that this began as a big bang, the universe bursting into existence from a point of infinitely dense and hot material. So today scientists believe that the creation started from an infinitely dense and hot material and expands and expanded and still expanding. So something like this. So it's expanding. So that's what the Big Bang theory states. But is it the only theory we have, or is there something else going on? Yes, this is the theory till now, whatever we have. And recently some scientists have come up with thinking about this one, saying that this universe also contracts. So that is, however, a study of the early universe has revealed it could have been formed from an older collapsing universe rather than being brand new. So what the scientists are now thinking about is experimenting on the early stages of the creation of the universe. They're understanding that there was an older collapsing universe, and from the collapsing universe, the Big Bang has started. So that means there was a universe previously, it started collapsing, and now due to Big Bang, it started expanding. That means it's going to collapse once again, and again it's going to expand. So this is the relevance with that mantra, whatever we have seen previously. So our universe could have been formed from an older universe collapsing. So this is what the scientists at present are thinking. And whatever I'm talking about the science is given in that web page there, http://3tags.org/article/our-universe-could-have-been-formed-from-an-older-universe-collapsing. So please visit that website. You'll completely read about how the scientists are thinking. So this is how it's contracting now. So it contracts, then expands. That's what the scientists are believing. So let's see this. So that contraction again expands from a Big Bang. So this is the so-called Big Bounce Theory. So the like Big Bang Theory, the Big Bounce Theory. So Dr. Stephen from Imperial College London and Dr. Neil, director of the Perimeter Institute for Theoretical Physics in Canada, have shown how this Big Bounce might be possible. So therefore, we have to understand that the Rig Veda Mantra, whatever I have shown you at the earlier stage for the first slide, so indicates that there was a universe previously and there is a universe now and there will be a universe in the future. So now the scientists are holding on to that theory. Let's hope one day they will be able to prove that. And I wish all of you go through Vedic mantras, and most of them will give you some good meaning about how the world has been created. And every mantra, we believe, is true to the core and stands for any scientific experiment. Thank you. Om.